Hi there, welcome back to the Adobe Spark page. Today we're going to go to the main page. We'll click the plus button at the top center. We're going to pick page this time, but we're going to deal with a different type of page than we dealt with in the previous session. We'll start off exactly the same as we would a Glideshow, title, subtitle, and photo. So we'll add our title, which I've pasted in here, a subtitle, which I've also pasted in here. We'll go to the plus. Remember, the first plus only gives us that opening photo to work with. So I'll go to the familiar upload photo button. Let's try this one this time. We'll move down. We'll add the CSU logo real quickly. So I'll go to photo, upload photo, and we'll work with this one. And now on this plus button, we go to Glideshow. And here is where our workflow deviates from how we did the Adobe page previously. Rather than add our photos one at a time, we're going to add all our photos at once. Now you can switch around the order of these photos, you can delete them, you can add more, but the way to start is to throw a bunch of photos up there and then start to work with them. None of the decisions you make at this point, or at any point actually, are set in stone. So we're going to click upload photo, and we're going to choose all our photos at once. I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll choose 6 photos here. We might delete some of these later on. And here they are loaded up. Now to delete or move around the order of a photo, you click on it. What that allows you to do is replace it to move it up or down in your order or to delete it. We'll stick with these 6 for now and continue. Now, something that's a little counterintuitive at this point, if you go to click Edit Glideshow to continue, it's not a link. It's not working at all. You've got to save these 6 photos first, and you'll end up with full page view of these photos. We can scroll back up to see the stuff we've already put on. And then as I scroll down into this first picture, we get our first caption box. Now remember, our previous caption box in the previous flavor of working with the page, all we had was add caption here, and all we had was the capability of adding text. With this plus, however, we can add photos, text, buttons, and video. So let's add a few of those elements now. We'll start with the text button. I'll click it, and I'll control V in the information I want to be there. Let's click within these and we'll make them H1s so that they are quite large. And then below this, we'll use the plus button, we'll use photo, and what I'm going to use here is a screenshot from a Google map of where that is. So there's our first panel, tells us when and where, and gives us a map. We'll keep going to our next image. We'll drag this over to the right, as we did in the last time we used an Adobe Spark page. This time I'm going to add in some more text. I'll click inside the box, click the plus. We'll work with text again, and I have this preloaded into my clipboard. This is 2 sentences long. Let's divide up those 2 sentences so that it doesn't give the end user a big block of text to attempt to go through. That's all we'll do with this picture. We'll go to our next one. We'll drag this panel to the center and we'll add content. We'll click the plus. We'll start with text. I'll paste it in and then I will click it. We'll center it. And then just below this, we'll put in a video. So we'll use the URL of the video we want to work with. Here's that URL. So we'll paste it in and save. Our video appears. And then on our last picture here, I'll click the plus. I'll go to text. I'll paste in our call to action here. I'll click within my text again, and I'll center it. And let's go with an H2 on this to make it stand out a little more. We'll scroll down. Don't really need this picture, so we'll need to go to and edit our slideshow to get rid of it. I'm going to click here in the picture, and I have edit photos, focal point, and delete. Focal point is if you want to focus on a different part of the picture as it scrolls down. It doesn't so much work left or right because it's a full screen picture, but you can move the focal point up or down fairly easily. You do not want to hit delete, as delete deletes the entire Glideshow. I'll click it, and it says this cannot be undone, so we'll click cancel to let you know that is a scary button to touch. And then we'll click edit photos, which is what we wanted to do in the first place. And we simply want to delete this last one. We'll save it again. And that gives us this bottom blank space, since this is now our last picture. And here we'll put in a button with El Paso County extension. There's our text. Our URL comes next. We'll center the button, click save. Let's add a brought to you by just above it. Brought to you by, and we will capitalize brought. And then we'll finish off with a, let's center this. We'll finish off with a logo. So we'll click photo. I'll go to the familiar upload photo button, and let's work with this one this time. We can go fill screen if you want, which makes it too big. We can go full width, which makes it a little smaller, but logos generally work best as online. And with all that done, though we have a pretty good idea of how this works as it scrolls, let's click preview and look at the entire thing. Here's our opening screen with our title and subtitle, our logo, our first picture with our panel on the left with the map and the directions on how to get there, our second picture, a couple of sentences of text, our third picture, which has a bit of text and a video, and finally the call to action. And we end up with our Glideshow over, and we have a button and the CSU logo. So that is how to work with a Adobe Spark page Glideshow version. I'm going to get rid of the preview, and as before, I can share this on Adobe Spark. I need to pick a category. I can keep my name on or off this, and I can have it on or off the Adobe Spark page. We'll keep it off because this is not a real event. We'll click Create Link, and then we have a link, or we'll eventually have a link that we can work with to share this slideshow. There's the link. We can share it directly on Facebook, Twitter, email, or get some embed code, or we can simply spread this link around via emails, websites, other types of social media. One final note, when you're done with your page, whether it's a Glideshow or a standard page, you can go up here to the upper right-hand corner, choose themes, and choose a different theme. Themes affect the fonts mostly. There are a few background colors involved that are changed as well, and it will also change some of the animation behaviors. I'll go to Luca, which also seems to fit this show nicely, so you can see how this affects your text and your background colors.